Welcome to Expressive Power Flow. Something that I just wanted to share a little moment before we start. A dear human being and beautiful soul here in Las Vegas, Dre Gardner, a little shout out to him, has encouraged me to start, and I have been doing this every day, a little gratitude bucket or basket or whatever, if you have an old shoebox or something. I'm using a wine bucket because we're not pouring as much champagne as I'd like in the house. But every morning or afternoon, just writing a little bit of why you are grateful, especially in these moments, in these times, folding it up. And then, you know, a few months from now, a year from now, however long, you go back and you start reading those things and seeing just why you can be so grateful. But I just wanted to share that. Get comfy and come up on your beautiful toes. We're gonna start in Tadasana or Mountain Pose. And I think my cat, as usual, is going to try and join us for this. She'll be our little guide. So when you come up to any standing position, you really want to feel yourself rooting down. So that connection, just ground those heels in first and then place the balls of the feet. So while you're here, let's roll the shoulders back, bring the palms of the hands facing upwards, and let's just bring the toes up off the mat. And you can really feel yourself grounding further. The spine wants to elongate naturally, the crown of the head being lifted even higher, and the pelvic floor comes up a little bit. So if you're here and you don't know what that pelvic floor tilting upwards kind of means, imagine that you're trying to zip a tight pair of pants and you kind of have to squeeze the thighs and lift yourself up a little bit. Imagine that and find yourself in this position. Take a nice deep breath in through the nose and release, sigh it out, let the lips part. Take a look around you, find your surroundings, find comfort there, and gently close the eyes. You can drop the toes now. Seal the lips as we begin our Ujjayi breath. Fog up that mirror in front of your face with your breath, really steaming it out through the nostrils. Allow the corners of the mouth to rise gentle, softening each muscle in the face. Feel the strength in your legs as those muscles are engaged, rooting down, helping you connect mind, body, and breath here. Bringing your awareness and attention to the breath coming in through the nose. And exhale, steam out that mirror in front of you, big oceanic breath. Taking another deep inhale, let's set your intention for the day, for your practice. And as we move through our practice together today, let's ask what the universe needs of me today. Bring the palms together just in front of the heart center. Keep the shoulders rolling down the spine, the navel engaged. Maybe that smile growing brighter as you accept and acknowledge your own body and your presence here today, creating a little more hope and a little more strength to share with others. Gently open the eyes, gaze down to those beautiful fingertips. Perhaps they seem vibrating with a bit of energy already. And inhale, reach those arms up and overhead, slight back bend. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, halfway raise again. You can bend at the knees slightly. Exhale, drop the hands down. You can walk, or if you're ready and warmed up, jump the feet back to plank. Hold here. Make sure the palms are flat, fingertips are spread wide. Engage that core. I'm just going to start turning on the mat. So awaken the whole full body experience here. As we inhale, we're going to lift that right leg sky high. Try and draw the arms up and back. Lift through the leg. Lift those hips, point that right toe, drop the head. Really press off from the hands. Keep the breath flowing, ujjayi, in through the nose and back out through the mouth. Let's bend that right knee 90 degrees. Twist and turn, gaze up and under the right arm. For those that want to add that little bit of heat already, we can twist and flip over, lift those hips high. Honor your body, connect with your edge today. Find that juicy heat. Two more breaths. On your next exhale, swing and flip back around. Straighten that right leg and exhale, swing it through. Foot comes between both hands. We're gonna drop that left foot 45 degrees. Inhale as you square the hips and the shoulders towards the front. Warrior one. Sink a little further into your lunge. Now, for all of you out there following, go ahead, sink lower. I had a hip replacement recently, so I modify for myself. I find my own edge. Arms lifted. Turn those pinkies slightly in. Drop the shoulders down the spine. And let's breathe together. So you want to try and really connect the ball and the outer ball of that left foot. Don't roll in towards the inside of the foot. Try and keep it on the outside more. Two more breaths.
You can walk, you can dance.
And on your next inhale, we're going to come up to the ball of that left foot. Exhale, bring the palms together. Draw them down to your heart center. First, twist to the right side and sink that left elbow above the right knee. You want to bring the palms of the hands in front of the heart center. That back leg nice and strong and tall, no dipping down. And here, since we're twisting through the digestive system, let's really steam it out with that power breath, like shh. You can almost feel it, just taking out all that toxin and unnecessary energy down there.
These cats no match. Plus, they like a certain natural rap and chase them, but they never catch the wagon.
Three more breaths.
What's happening? It's back when they have body issues. It's not
easy. You want to add that spice? You can open up the wing.
My thoughts is too advanced for the artists on these labels. They come sweeter than safe from the swamp of the mashed potato. I try to talk to the
one more deep breath in as you exhale. Turn to the front. Extend those wings forward and out. Palms facing forward. Hold here. Keep that breath flowing.
Big Ohio status. What you want, money is classic.
Two more breaths. Shaking just in mind you how alive you are. Exhale, drop those palms down. Come back to plank. That should feel nice to stretch that right leg out. Hold here. Keep the navel drawn in. Palms flat, fingers spread. And on your next exhale, hips come sky high, joining your downward dog. Again, pressing off from the palms. Turn and rotate those elbows in. Draw the navel in and up. Drop the head. And inhale, as you lift that left leg sky high, point the toe. Press off from the mat. And bend that knee, drop it over to the right side, gaze up and under the left arm. For those that want to add that extra heat, slowly, gently flip over. Lift those hips up, breathe through the nose and back out through the nose. Create that smooth current in the breath. Two more breaths. And as you exhale, flip back around if you were there, straighten the leg. And exhale, swing it through the hands. Square the shoulders and hips towards the front as you drop that back foot. 45 degrees. Inhale, reach the arms up and overhead. Adjust the body as needed. If you don't feel like you're in the right position, check your feet. Front feet facing forward, the back foot 45 degrees. Arms up, shoulders back through the spine. Pinkies turning in. Heart center reaching upwards. Feeling happy and grateful for being on the mat today.
Be the new one born to shine. Take the blue on the
side. Try and lift those titties off the mat so you know that you're grounded in.
All you have to do is cry.
One more deep breath. Exhale, palms come together overhead. Exhale, as you turn that right foot to the ball, drop the palms. Turn to the left, drop that elbow. And start to steam out the breath. Hands in front of the heart center. Twist, keep that back leg nice and strong and tall. Shh. Open up if you want to add that extension. Two more breaths. On your next exhale, turn towards the front. Extend those wings, spread those fingers out. Keep that back leg nice and strong. Two more breaths here, navel drawn in. Beautiful, feel that heat and juiciness. Drop those palms. Left comes back to meet the right. Join me in plank. Ah, wonderful.
Won't you be the new one born to shine?
And on your next inhale, slowly bring that right knee between the thumbs. Soften that left knee, soften to the back of the left foot.
All you have to do is cry.
Find your balance, engage that core. On your next exhale, draw that left toe in towards the sit bones. Honor your edge if you have your yoga blocks or your books or even your cans, you can use them as balancers. If you want to add that spice and heat, swing that beautiful wing back and around. Find your bind. Reach the gaze up, so we've got our heart centers open. We're gonna use a nice sound breath of H-A, like, ah. Feel that vibration, adding a little bit of heat and energy connecting through the lungs, the cages, the heart center. Three more breaths. Wherever you are, honor yourself. You want to make sure you're not rolling off that front knee or the front shin. One more breath. And release, slowly release that back leg. Palms come down and drop that forehead in front of the right knee. You can rock side to side slightly, opening up the hips a little more. And lifting the body up. We're just gonna walk or guide that right foot towards the outer edge of the mat. Again, we want to stay on that back knee, the back shin. So if you want, you can always put something on the underside of your right hip. Give yourself a little support there. Just bring the foot in a little closer to the body if you are lifted up. And we're gonna inhale, reach the arms up and overhead. Exhale, slowly come down. Control this movement with your core. Walk the hands out a little bit. Let the forehead drop. If this again is a little too much, you can use your props. You can make your fists into little pillows. Control the flow here as your body needs it.
Feel your smoky mist up to the stratosphere. Too low to find my way, too high to wonder why. I've touched this place before, so we're in another time.
Three more breaths. Feel the gentle rise and fall of the belly.
Half a million thoughts are going through my mind.
And as you exhale here, bring the palms to the other sides of the face. Lift the heart center up, roll the shoulders back, curl that back foot, lift the body. And we're just gonna take that right leg and stretch it out, pointing the toe. It's about 3 inches off the mat, gaze is forward. Holding here, almost there, should feel really fun now. And exhale, bring both knees to the center of the mat. Drop down to child's pose. Great job. Oh, wonderful. Feeling the juiciness. On your next inhale, gently rise back, tabletop, curl the toes under, hips go sky high, downward dog. And on your next exhale, gently guide that left knee forward between the thumbs. Soften to the back of the knee, back of the foot. Square the hips and heart towards the center. Rock gently side to side. Get those hips open a little more. And again, you can hold here with your props. You can leave the hands here. Add that spice, extending the arms. Bring that right foot in towards the sit bone. Connect here.
Touched this place before, so we're in another time. Now I can
draw the navel in towards the lower back. Let's use that AK. Shout out loud with the breath. Ah, wonderful. Feel that vibration. Three more breaths. One more deep breath as you exhale. Gently let go of that leg. Palms come down. You're going to walk that left foot towards the outer edges of the mat. Again, find your edge. Walk maybe that right foot back a little more. Rock side to side.
with the clip on tight and a rub on tan. He's got me running around the office like a dog around a track. When I get back home, you're always there to rock.
And inhale, reach those beautiful wings up and overhead. As you exhale, slowly come down. Walk the hands out if you can, drop the forehead. Stay on that knee on the right leg. Don't roll around.
Making pointless calls. I got a desk full of paper that means nothing at all. Sometimes I catch myself staring into space, counting down the hours till I get to see your face. Hey, Julie, look what they're doing to me, trying to trip me up, trying to wear me down. Julie, I swear it's so hard to bear it, and I'd never make it through without you around. No, I'd never make it.
One more deep breath as you exhale, palms come to the sides of the face. Lift the heart center up. And we're going to curl that back foot and lift the body. We're going to extend that left leg out, point the toe, about 3 inches off the mat. Square the shoulders to the front. Arms are straight. Almost. One more deep breath. And exhale, both knees come down. Back to child's pose for 3 breaths.
Day for a mean little guy with a bed to pay and a soup stain tie. He's got me running around the office like a turbo on a wheel. He can tell me what to do, but he can't tell me.
Inhale as you come back up, come to tabletop. Curl the toes under, lift the hips, come back to downward dog. Let's pedal the feet out as we walk our dog. Slow, powerful. Draw the knees in, gaze up and under the opposite arm. Really start to open the cages. One breath for each movement. And come back to center. Inhale, reach the gaze forward as you draw that left foot back between the hands. Find your balance. We're going to sock into that back knee. Sock into the back of the foot. Inhale, reach the arms up and overhead. Exhale, swing them back behind you. Clasp them. Let's try and keep those palms as tight together as you can, and back bend. So you can sink a little further into your lunge here. Make sure that front knee isn't overstepping the big toe. Heart center up to the sky. Maybe a big smile on your face. And gently release the arms. We're going to straighten that front leg and come rest down onto our sit bones, flexing that front toe. And inhale, come back to 90 degrees. And exhale, gently rocking back and forth, flexing that toe as you come back on the sit bones. Draw the navel in, ujjayi breath. If you want to add that little bit of spice, you can drop the head down. Two more breaths. Come back, lift the heart center, hands high in the sky. Slide back then here. Open up the heart center again. And as you exhale, swing those wings back down. Lift and curl the toe up. Lift the body. Come back to your nice strong runner's lunge. Right leg nice and strong. And putting all the emphasis on that left foot. Let's start bringing our weight up onto it as we lift that back leg nice and strong. Flex the toe. Again, using your block, your hand, your book. If you want, let's bring those arms back behind us like we're taking flight. Shoulder blades running down the spine. Crown of the head reaching out. Hips aligned and one not lifting higher than the other. Breath flowing freely. Draw that navel in. Feel that connection in the left leg growing stronger. Almost. Two more breaths. On your next exhale, slowly start to swing that limb up. Coming right into 90 degrees, lift the arms up. Flex that front foot, engage those muscles, drop the shoulder blades down. And gently take hold, hands just underneath the knee, not on top, and sit back as if in a chair. Beautiful. Little firelight now coursing through the left side of the body. And exhale, gently let that right leg float down. Shake them out. Great job, guys. Woo! Little dance. And we're going to inhale, reach the wings up high in the sky. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway raise. Exhale, drop the palms. You can walk or jump the feet back to plank. On your next inhale, guide that right foot forward between the hands. Adjust as needed. And soften that left knee, soften to the back of the left foot. Inhale, reach the arms up and overhead. Swing them back behind you, clasp those hands, and arch. Beautiful. Send that heart center up to the sky. Send your intentions there. Lunge a little further. Beautiful. Two more breaths. And gently release. Bring the arms back up. Play back then. Palms come down. Let's curl that back foot. Lift yourself back to runner's lunge. Now find your focus on the mat, the floor, the wall. Ground that right foot in. Feel the connection as you start to bring the weight up onto the right foot, lifting that left leg. Now balance definitely will be a little different on each side. You come out of it. See, I've got a little helper here. I didn't even plan that, but I love having it. It's good to have friends some days. So flex that back foot. If you want, you can extend those arms like you're shooting off, going into flight. Keep the breath rolling. Feel that connection. For two more breaths. And as you exhale, we're going to swing gently, more gently than I. Bring those arms straight up above you and bring that left leg 90 degrees. Flex that front foot, engage the muscles. And slowly, gently lower those hands. Sit back into your leg. Shoulders rolling back and down the spine. And exhale.
exhale, let that left float down to the right. Shake it out. Whew, good job. I'm feeling a little juicy. And inhale, reach the arms up and overhead again. Swan dive down. And let's hold here. Let the head drop. You can have a nice bend in the knees. Honor yourself. If you start here, just try and figure out each moment or each day that you're practicing, try and stretch the legs a little straighter each time. In the shower is always a great spot. It's nice and warm. And we're gonna take those beautiful peace fingers, wrap them around the big toes if you got them. And we're gonna stretch the elbows out towards the outer wall, bringing the crown of the head down even further. Again, you can stay with bended knees. Let's seal the lips, Ujjayi breath. Two more breaths. And exhale, release. Again, we're gonna inhale, reach the arms up and overhead. Exhale, bring them out first, palms down, fingertips spread. So a nice T here. And we're just gonna work ourselves to our warrior two. So we're gonna start with our right foot. So here, since your left foot is already facing forward, you leave that right there. Make sure it's grounded in. We're gonna extend outwards. You can adjust as needed. You're gonna extend that right foot out and start to sink into that lunge. This way, you can really gauge your front heel should be in the middle of that back foot, which is turned towards your screen here. Extend those arms, spread those fingers. Front knee stays just behind that big toe and reach the gaze towards the right middle finger. So as warriors, we like to stay present and grounded. We are aware of the past and excited about the future. I feel like I gotta crawl through a jungle with this song. Two more breaths. And exhale as you straighten that front leg. We're just gonna exhale, drop that right hand down, keep that left hand raised high. So wherever you want to be, if you want to put your hand on the inside of the shin, that's fine. If you can reach the floor, go for it. Honor your edge. If you have your blocks and your props, go ahead and put them on the outside of your foot and rest your hand there. We've got our hearts open. Big H-A sound breath here. Gaze up to the middle finger of the left hand. Two more breaths. And on your next exhale, bend back into that warrior two. Lift up. Center yourself once again. You're gonna turn that right foot now forward. Come back to center. Inhale as you elongate and exhale, bring the crown of the head down towards the floor. Hands reaching out towards the toes. Placing both palms down on the floor. Let's lift up, halfway raise, nice flat back. Draw the navel back towards that lower back. And we're gonna walk the hands forward, come up on the tippy toes. As we inhale here, exhale, draw yourself back. Bring the hands back behind you if you can. Elbows connecting inwards. Inhale, walk the hands back forward. Heart center up and over fingertips. And let's steam it back here.
We got this afternoon. You got this room. One thing I've left to do. Discover me.
One more breath.
One mile to
halfway raise, gaze forward. Let's place the hands on the hips. Really engage that core as you gently lift the body sky high. Inhale, reach those wings up and over. Palms down to your heart center, gaze upon your fingertips. Let's bring that heart rate down just a little bit. Let the blood and oxygen flow down the body. And from here, let's keep that right foot facing the screen. We're going to turn that left foot out towards the opposite wall. Spread those wings out. Keep the shoulders even. Spread the fingers and sink into your lunge. Bring the body to center. Remember, we don't want to reach to the future. We don't want to get stuck in the past. Stay in the present moment. So what you want to focus on here, we want to keep the navel drawn in, but that back foot, we want to try and roll to the outer edge of the foot, like the ball of the outer edge. If you feel yourself lifting up, just focus on bringing that back down. Gaze to the middle finger. That is wonderland. Thanks, down there.
Your body is a wonderland,
I use my hands. Your body is a wonderland, I never lose. Two more breaths. You guys are rocking it. On the next exhale, we're going to come into our triangle as we straighten that left leg. Exhale. Bring the body down. Boop, 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 boop. Again, honor your edge wherever you'd like to be. Hands can be here. Hands can be on the outside with a prop or flat on the mat on the inside of the left foot. Gaze up towards that right middle finger. Really open up the chest here. Feel it as you bring that vibration of sound through with HA. Yeah, let's get juicy. Woo! How grateful are you today for your own body being here, connected? Bringing all that energy and hope into the world. Da-da-da-da-da. And one more deep breath. As you exhale, we're going to drop that hand down. Curl that right foot. Sink into that front foot. Drop the other palm. Draw the foot back. Oh, yeah. Guess where we're at? We are in our plank. As if we couldn't tell, I like planking. And exhale, hips come sky high, downward dog. Yeah, smooth out that spine.
A thousand empty windows.
And let's hollow out the back here as we come up on our tippy toes. Draw the navel in. Chin comes towards the chest. And you're just going to draw that left foot in towards the hands, towards the center of your mat, and just on the back side of it.
Now this is too, this is enough. Go ahead and leave it here. If you want to add some spice, bring that right foot and cross it at the ankles, holding here. Really hollow out the back. And exhale, release back to downward dog. Inhale, lift, come up on the tippy toes, hollow the back out. Now bring that right foot, bottom of it on the mat. You can bring that left foot in, hollow yourself out, and exhale back to downward dog. This is the beginning of the Lolasana. So we're just getting our move and our core stronger and stronger every day to do this. Yeah. One more on each side. The closer you get, the harder it's going to be. And for all of you who are advanced and want to go through the full Lolasana, go ahead and lift off. And come back to downward dog. As we exhale, we're just going to draw that left hand in inside of the right ankle. Take gentle hold if you can. Stretch and reach the gaze up and under the right arm. Smile. And exhale, release. Smooth through one breath. Deep breath as you exhale. Right hand, left ankle. Gaze through the left arm. I remember my first yoga mix that I ever made. This song was on it. I love it. Good old Amos Lee. And exhale, palms come down. Breathe into the cages. Stretch them out a little more. As you exhale, hollow out the back. Come back to plank. We're going to lower down. Keep those elbows close to the body. Slower than you thought you could. Palms flat. Low plank, hold here if you want. Add some heat and spice. Lift that right leg, cross it on the left ankle. You can do it, hold here. Switch left on top of the right. Almost there. And back to high plank, woohoo! Yeah, drop both knees. Open wide on the mat. Rock back onto the sit bones, child's pose. Stretch those wings out in front of you. Woo! Walk the hands back in as you lift the body up slightly. Place that left palm down, fingers spread, reaching forward in the middle of your mat. Inhale, reach that right arm up and above. We're gonna thread the needle. So palm comes up facing the head. You're going to swing it underneath that left arm. Drop that right ear down towards the mat. Don't worry if you lift up off the sit bones. You want to get that ear down as close to your mat as you can. Breathe through any tightness. And yeah, I wonder sometimes why my breath doesn't clear away all the tightness, but we just keep working on it. And on your next inhale, slowly start to lift the body as you exhale, pushing off with that right palm, palms come down. Smooth out the spine through one breath and exhale. Lift that left arm sky high and thread the needle through the right arm. Left ear comes down to the mat. If you want to open yourself up even more, binders can take your binds as well, or just rest here. Ah.
and inhale. As you exhale, lift the body up. We're gonna cross the ankles and swing over to an easy seated posture. Spread out the feet, spread the legs out. Just give them a little shape. Roll the shoulders back. Roll them forward. Flex those toes. Inhale, reach the arms up and overhead. Extend up and over. Peace fingers come down. Grab those big toes if you got them. Elbows come out. And exhale. Draw the crown of the head towards the thumbs. Exhale as you slowly walk the hands back towards the body. Draw that left foot in. Give yourself a little squeeze here. Rock side to side. Keep that front foot flexed. And we're just going to place that left foot above the right knee. Flex this foot here. Keep both feet flexed. And we're just going to rest. So this is kind of getting us used to the idea of going into lotus or half lotus. You can give your little foot a nice little massage here. Make sure those feet stay flexed though. As we do this now, very carefully, I'm just gonna move forward a little bit on my mat. So you wanna keep the feet flexed. You're gonna start rolling back as you gently take the inside of the right leg, just under the knee, above the knee, pardon, not just under the knee. You don't want to hurt yourself. You're going to thread that left arm between the legs so it connects with the right hand. And we're just going to roll back. Try and control the roll with your core. Connect one vertebrae at a time and come back, pulling that right knee in towards the body. Shoulders come down. Yeah, feet are both flexed, very important. Lower back secured on the mat. And exhale, we're gonna flatten that right leg, bring that left to meet it, and engage, lift your body up once again. Sit bones firmly planted in, flex those feet. As you draw that right leg now, drop it above that left knee. And again, different sides will feel differently. This side of mine, woo, needs some love from that new hip. Just making sure you're honoring your own body, flexing both the feet. So as we start to roll back onto the spine, we're gonna start bending that left leg. We're gonna thread the needle. So we're gonna take that right arm through the right leg, connect it, and gently start to roll back. Draw that left knee in towards the body. And exhale. Let's straighten both the legs above us. Keep the feet flexed. Drop the palms. And slower than you thought you ever could, we're going to start to lower those heels down to the earth. Keep that breath flowing all the way through. Knowing that soon you shall rest your body on Mother Earth. Feel that connection. Close the eyes. Perhaps sighs, release and let go.
Close the eyes. Your attention to the breath coming in through the nose and back out through the nostrils. Bring your attention and awareness now to the full feeling of your body, rested, strong, and full of bright hope and energy. The blood and oxygen flowing freely, a smooth current of the breath channeling through the body as you breathe in through the nose and exhale, release, feeling that connection through the in and the out breath. Your awareness now as the breath travels into the nose, parting the lips and exhaling a sigh of gratitude. As your spirit and mind reconnect with your body, you ask the universe, what do I need from you today? And now as three become one, I ask you, what can you accomplish together? As you breathe in through the nose, take special notice of your body, strong, energetic, and full of hope. Feel the connection of the earth supporting you, the smooth breath, the smile on your face growing brighter, as you acknowledge just how beautiful, creative, and full of wisdom you truly are. And with this knowledge and acceptance rolling over onto one side, giving yourself a beautiful, gentle hug, and knowing that you are all there is, and all there is love. And when you're ready to share that love, join me in an easy seated posture as we seal this day, seal the intentions and our practice with three resonating ohms. For our lives, families, jobs, friends, I ask that we are blessed in peace, harmony, bliss, joy, love, and light. Namaste.
Namaste.
Beautiful. I hope some of you got a little juicy and connected and that you felt that vibrant energy. I surely did. Oh, hey. So another day of a pink sort of connected, rooted color. Which really kind of helps us focus on that sacrum and feeling our inner sort of love light and childlike nature. So today is pink and we're going to let love in. So I encourage you all,
It's Tuesday. Whatever that means to you in these days, I want you to let all the love in that you can and share it. Now, if you're by yourself, let yourself in. Find a way today to say some really beautiful things to yourself. Write down what you're grateful for. Tell yourself that you are the most beautiful, creative, and full of wisdom person today at this moment. Because if we can't love ourselves, then it's really hard to engage and find the connection that we need to love the rest of the world. So tomorrow, back again at 9 a.m. for a nice expressive yoga flow, 75 minutes of hopefully pure ecstasy on your parts, because it is for me, I think. I'm pretty sure it will be. Thank you all. I will see you tomorrow.
Bye,
Namaste.
Bye,
Here.